Alrighty now, crew, welcome back, welcome back, welcome back. Hope all is well under the circumstances. Hope no one is sick. And if you do get sick, I hope you recover very quickly. So I'm doing a fill today. These are Muffin's hands. Say hi, Muffin! So her nails are 3.5 weeks old. So a couple days ago, she hit her pinky. She was cleaning her room. She hit her pinky nail on a chair in her room. And the tip of her pinky swole up. And it was like very tender to touch. So I was like, oh my gosh, I have to remove the polish. I have to look at your nails. I have to make sure it's not lifting or anything like that. So I decided to wait till the swelling went down, which it took about 2 or 3 days to do. And it's still a little bit tender to touch, but the nails didn't lift or crack or anything like that. The integrity of her nail plate and her nail bed looks really good. So I am safe to do a fill. So I went ahead and fouled everything off camera and I prepped her nails off camera as well. I did a really good detailed prep video. My last video that I posted was a really good prep detailed video. So if you guys are wondering how I prep or what my new updated prep routine looks like, you can click that video and I will put a link in the description box below. So anyway, I added the No Lifts primer and I let that dry. Now I'm going in with my base coat gel polish. The base coat that I'm using today is from the Gel Bottle Ink. You guys know that's my favorite right now. However, any base coat polish will work. And I also have, if you guys are bored, I also have a base coat testing video where I tested all my base coats and I believe it was like over 20 polishes that I tried. Don't quote me, but it was really close to about 20 polishes. So if you're in the market for a really good base coat polish, I would suggest you watch that video before making an investment. So anyway, after I added the primer, I let that dry and then I go in with my base coat. You guys can do 2 coats of primer if you prefer, but I'd rather do 1 coat of primer and then 1 coat of base coat gel. For me, that gives the best adhesion. It works really well, especially for people that have their hands in water all the time. If your hands are always in the water all the time, if you're a hairdresser, if you are a housekeeper, if you wash a lot of dishes, things like that, it's really good to paste your nails with gel polish because acrylic is more porous, meaning that it has like tiny, tiny little holes in it after it cures. So it's more porous than gel. So if you base your nails with gel, water, dyes, chemicals, things like that have a harder time penetrating through the gel than it does with acrylic. So you might find that even though you do everything perfectly right and you are a master at acrylics and they still may lift a little bit because the person has their hand in water or chemicals all the time, try to base your nails with gel polish and see if that helps you a little bit. See if that decreases your lifting problem because gel is less porous than acrylic. Alrighty, so now that the nails are prepped and primed and fully cured for 60 seconds, we get to add acrylic. I love adding acrylic. Aside from adding bling, I feel like adding acrylic is my favorite step and it goes by so quickly. Prepping for me, you guys already know, we talk about this all the time, but prepping for me takes forever. I think it takes me I got it down to 15 minutes, but anywhere between 15 and 20 minutes to prep the nails alone. And then boom, I add the acrylic on in like 10 minutes. You know, that's the best part for me, adding the acrylic, and it goes on so quickly. So anyway, I am applying small beads of acrylic because these nails are short and I don't need to rebalance her apex. I just need to do a real quick, simple fill. So it's going to go by so quickly and just making me so sad. I do want to let you guys know I am using a size 12 brush. I got this question, I want to say about 2 or 3 days ago in my inbox on Instagram. Someone asked me, what's a good starting size brush for beginners? And I told her anywhere from an 8 to a 12. A size 8 brush, I feel like is really good if you have small hands or if you're doing someone's nails with really small nail plates or nail beds, then you want to use a size 8 brush. But this one is a size 12 and I like it. It's not too big. It's nice. It's already crimped and it's round at the edge. I hate those brushes that are pointy. I don't like those pointy tip brushes. And I know a lot of you probably love them and they work great for you, but personal preference, I rather a nice flat rounded edge brush. I feel like that gives me a cleaner, nicer application. And I feel like it's easier for me to clean up the cuticle area with a flat, round kind of tip brush, you know? So that's my personal preference. So that's what I told the person in my DM. If you're watching, hey girl, hey, hey girl, hey. So yeah, anywhere from a size 8 to a size 12 is a good starting place. Most brush companies, the sizes will vary. So one brush size 12 might look like a size 8 in another company. So you have to be careful with that. I know Enel Couture, their size 12 brush is really good too. You know, the pink one that I use all the time, that's a good starting brush as well. If you can't find this one that I was just using, I think that's a good place to start. Who else has really good brushes? Model Ones, although they're having issues with their shipping and things like that now, they have a really good brush, y'all. They have a really good brush. I would suggest trying Model Ones brushes. And I do have a coupon code. So if you guys want to save some coins, check out my description box, order their brush, use my code. So anyway, I applied a thin layer of acrylic to all her nails. And now I'm just doing a quick file. There wasn't a lot of touch-up filing that needed to be done, so I'll just speed it up. But I do want to point out that I file the nails forward, so facing forward and flat. And then I like to flip the hand up and file from the client's view as well, because they're going to be looking at their hands for the next 2 or 3 weeks. They are going to be looking at their nails and hands. You want them to have a nice view. So I file at my view, then I flip up and I file at their view. Now I'm going in with my e-file. The e-file that I have is from Belle. I don't know if my coupon code is still valid, you guys, but I will leave it in the description box below. You can try it. This is a good e-file. I use it almost every day. I really, really love it. The handpiece is small enough for my small hands, but sometime this week or early next week, I'll be doing another drill review video for you guys because I have two more drills to try. Two. One is a upright desk drill and the other one is a portable. So stay tuned for that. Also of note, guys, the drill bit that I'm using, this is a safety drill bit. This is a safety ceramic drill bit. You can get it on Amazon. So it will be in my Amazon storefront below. So all you have to do is click on the link, go to where it says e-files, drills, and drill bits and things like that. You'll see a bunch of my favorite drill bits and drills and stuff. But this ceramic safety drill bit is really good. I have it in coarse and I use the coarse to remove like product or debulking acrylic and things like that, but the medium grit, this is really good for finish filing. If you guys are new to using the e-file, or you're like timid or you think you're gonna cut somebody or something like that, try a ceramic medium drill bit with a safety piece and I think you'll be fine. This kind of drill bit gives you the confidence to get close to the cuticle area because you know you're not going to hurt them. You know, obviously you still have to be careful. You still can't apply too much pressure and things like, you can't have the drill way up high, things like that. But I feel like a drill bit like this will give you the confidence to use your e-file a little bit more, practice with your e-file and things like that. All right, so now that I'm done with the filing, I just sprayed her hands with some alcohol and I'm wiping it off with a lint-free paper towel just so that there's no lint or dust when I go to apply my polish. So the color she chose is this beautiful blue color from Madame Glam. It's called Fresh Me Up. Fresh Me Up. And I do have coupon codes from Madame Glam as well. So link to everything I use will be in the description box below. If I have a coupon code, it will be there. If I don't, then I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. But I do have a code for this beautiful blue. Beautiful. Oh my gosh, it's gorgeous. And I've had this color for a while and it's just kind of been sitting on my polish rack. You know, when I go to do my nails, I never think of colors like this. Like, I really don't feel like colors like this will fit me. But Muff will come in and she say, I want a blue. And I'm pulling out like dark blues, like blues that I like. And she's like, no, I want a light blue. And I'm like, light blue? What? And she was like, yes, I want light blue. So I'm like, okay. So I pull out this one and she was like, yes, that's the one I want. So I was like, all right, here we go. But then when I apply the first coat, y'all, this is one coat. One coat. I didn't even do the second coat yet. Full coverage. So anyway, when I apply the first coat, I'm like, oh, well, okay. This is gorgeous. It is beautiful. This is a gorgeous sky blue. This is a beautiful sky blue. You know, it's like a cheery, happy color. And we need some cheery, happy vibes going on with all this coronavirus crap. I am so over coronavirus, you guys. I'm so over. I know that it is a real virus. I know that it is real. I still feel like the way that it came about is not what we're being told. I know that we were told that someone in China ate bat, rat, monkey soup, something weird like that. I know, but they've been doing weird stuff like that for decades. Like, that's part of their culture. So I know that, but I just feel like the media is twisting things and I just don't know their angle. I'm giving the media a side eye right now because I'm just fed up. I don't know if I should stay in the house and just quarantine myself or continue to go to work because I am a medical professional. I do have an obligation to go to work and take care of these patients. But at the same time, I don't want to bring anything home to my family. So I'm really having a hard time deciding if I should go to work or stay home. So anyway, that's neither here nor there. Back to this blue. You see how I get off on these tangents, guys? I'm so sorry. I'm just so sorry. I don't even know how looking at this blue gorgeous color took me to a deep dark place such as COVID-19, but I'm sorry. I'm reeling it back. So here we go. Back to this beautiful blue color. So I'm going to go ahead and let that cure for 60 seconds. And I am applying the second coat. This does not need two coats, you guys. I don't know why I decided to do two coats. I really don't, to be honest, because you don't need it. And a lot of times when I have nice, thick, full coverage polish, I just do one coat. And that's going to A, save time. Right? That's going to save time, but it's also going to save money let's just be honest, right? We're going to save money. We're going to do one coat instead of two, especially if they don't need it. And we're going to save time and we're going to save money. So anyway, to complement that nice light sky blue, I'm going to add some white spider gel. The spider gel is from Yoyogi. I do have coupon codes for Yoyogi as well. And then I have some bling. Muff isn't too happy about the bling situation, but she said that I could do it. So I'm just going to take advantage. So I just want to point out, mind you, I just want to point out, Muff is not sitting down, okay? No. She's standing up. She's on her phone. Her brother entered the room, so she's turning around talking to him. It is hard to do her nails. It is hard to do her nails because she does not sit still. If you looked close while I was polishing her nails, you could see her hand was moving. She was jerking. Like, I'm like, oh my God, Jaden. I'm like yelling, Jaden, stop moving your head. Muffin, girl, stop moving. Like, the whole time I was polishing, I was like gripping her finger so hard and tight just to like let her stay still. And she wasn't staying still. Like, she was having full confidence. She was just doing the absolute most. Everything aside from tap dancing, okay? Like, she should have just put on some tap shoes and went to dancing because that's how much movement she was doing. So I'm so surprised she doesn't have polish going all down her arm. And that is the truth. Like, this was the hardest, shortest, quickest set ever. Like, the set was quick and easy, but hard at the same time because she was giving me a hard time. Oh my gosh, she was giving me a hard time. So anyway, anywho, you guys saw how I applied the spider gel. I do it the same every time, and I just really love spider gel. It just really gives the set like an extra oomph, you know, like a little boom, boom, pow. And it really would have looked nice if she had allowed me to do more than one color, like that nice white. But if I went on top with a black and or a pink or something like that, like a multicolor spider gel, I think that would have looked really, really pretty. But she was not having it. She said, no, just one color. And I had to give her what she wanted this time. I
A lot of times we fight back and forth, and it's like a power struggle because I'm the artist. I want to do what will look nice, but she's the customer, so she wants what she wants. And so we struggle a lot of times, and then we come up with a compromise. But today, I just did exactly what she wanted. She wanted a nice light blue. I gave her that. A little bit of nail art, only one color. I gave her that. And then, you know, she's not really into bling, but she let me add a little bling. And so that's that. So now the top coat that I'm using is the same top coat that I use all the time. It is from my girl Princess Nails by Diana. This top coat is thick, it's glossy, and it stays shiny for a long time. And I have not heard any bad reviews from everybody that I have suggested to purchase this top coat. They have all come back to me and say they really love it. No one has said anything bad about this top coat. So try it. If you guys are looking for a really good, shiny, creamy, buttery top coat, I suggest that you try it. And if you're looking for some really good acrylic, hello, I suggest you try mine. So link to all of the items that I used in this video will be in the description box below. I hope you really enjoyed this short, sweet set, and I will see you guys later. Bye.